Hey guys, glad to see you're all back for the fourth tutorial. In this edition, we are going to learn some basic stage construction. It's very simple, so it should be a short tutorial. Let's start. First, let's take a look at our project file from the previous tutorial. You can see that below the Marissa boss we created earlier, there is the stage group node. This node primarily controls the stage itself, but its name is important, as the name you put here is the name of the difficulty selected. So, if we change the name from spell card to, for example, normal, in the top right corner of the in-game screen, normal mode will be displayed. The other parameters this node holds is start life, which is the amount of lives you get when starting in this difficulty, start power, which is the amount of power you have when starting the game, and so is faith and bomb. Allow practice is a true or false check to know if you want this difficulty to be practicable. For example, extra stages would have to check this to be false. Difficulty value is just a parameter to define what is the internal difficulty value of this stage node. 1 is easy mode, 2 is normal mode, 3 is hard mode, 4 lunatic mode, and finally 5 is extra mode. In the stage node, the parameters are the same thing. However, if you want to have a stage progression, you should change the name of the stage node to whatever number is the stage you want it to be. For example, if you want it to be stage 1, then change the name of the stage node to be 1. The first node that is inside of the task of the stage is the code node. That has a function of load music inside of it. It is responsible for loading the music that plays on the stage for us. A music has to be loaded before playing it, so have that in mind. There is also an alternative for this node, which is the load background music node. It has the following parameters: path, which is where the music is located, resource name, which is the internal name of the song, loop end, which is when the loop of the song ends, and the loop length, which is how long the loop is. These two measures are in seconds, but you can use decimals to be more precise. Then we have the stage background node. Here you can select a background you would like for the stage to have. There are many default or preset backgrounds as shown on screen, so get the one you find that fits the most and let's see the next node. Play background music. This one just plays a song that you have loaded earlier. The arguments are name, which is internal music name, time, which is if you wanted to start at a specific point, and set stage time if you want to set the stage time. Yeah. After that, we have the create boss node, of which we have already seen in the previous tutorials, but I repeat for convenience. Name is the internal boss name, and wait is just to tell the stage to wait or not until the boss has been defeated to proceed. Now that we know how stages work and that they follow a simple route, we can start making simple enemy. But before that, let's add a wait node before the boss is created, just so that we can see what we are doing with the enemies. Go to the enemy tab and select create simple enemy with task. Its arguments are style, which is the enemy graphic, which all of them are appearing on screen right now. Well, not all of them, but there are some hidden ones, but I'm not gonna go deep in that topic yet. Anyway, hit point, which is the amount of health it has, position, which is where it will spawn, drop power, faith, or point, which will drop the amount of items you want, protect, which is how much time it will be invulnerable, clear bullets, which is if you want all bullets on screen to be deleted once the enemy dies, off-screen removal, which is to tell the game to kill the enemy once it goes too far off out of bounds, and contact damage, which is to enable or disable its collision box. For a test, I created a fairy slightly out of bounds so that she comes into the middle of the screen and then shoots a bullet as an example. I used nodes such as move to, play sound, and create simple bullets. Let's see how that goes. Great, just as expected. Here's another example of what we did, except in a similar way as to how defined bullets work. Simply define the enemy you want to use and then create it in the stage portion. It's going to work the same way our simple enemy did. So how about we create a simple second stage then? I renamed my stage group node to normal mode and gave it a difficulty value of 2 and renamed the stage node to 1. Then I created another stage after the first one and named it 2. At the end of our first stage, we can place the go to stage node and specify it to go to stage 2. I also shortened the time between the enemy spawning and the boss creation. Let's try playing it. As you could see, we started the first stage, killed our enemy, and then we had a boss fight. And once it ended, the game transitioned to the next stage, as you can see by the fade in and out and the background change that I had defined it to be the lake background on stage 2. As I said, it was a pretty short tutorial. Mess around with some functions from the object and enemy tab in your enemies and bosses and see what wonders they can do. Enemies are really flexible, so be sure to try out whatever comes up in your mind. And as always, in case you have any questions, post a comment here or join the Bullet Hell Engine server. There, we are building a really nice LuaSTG community, and I'm really thankful for everyone that has been joining it. I'm super happy to see people interested in this engine, and sorry that I didn't post any tutorial in the past 2 weeks. I was busy participating in the Demaku contest that the same server was hosting, and also some real-life problems. But anyways, enough of that. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time!